Hi friends. Welcome to another learning video on Pharma Guideline. Today we shall discuss the design qualification of equipment and systems. Design qualification, often abbreviated as DQ, refers to a documented process used in various industries, including pharmaceuticals, to ensure that a system or equipment design meets the intended requirements and specifications. It is typically carried out during the initial stages of a project or system development to ensure that the design is fit for its intended purpose and meets regulatory and quality standards. The design qualification process involves a thorough review and evaluation of the design documentation, such as design drawings, specifications, and other relevant documentation, to verify that the design is complete, accurate, and compliant with the defined requirements. It may also involve conducting tests, simulations, and risk assessments to identify and mitigate any potential design issues. Now, let us know the main objectives of design qualification. Verify that the design meets the intended requirements and specifications. Identify and address any design flaws or issues that may affect the performance, safety, or quality of the system or equipment. Ensure compliance with regulatory and quality standards. Establish a documented record of the design verification process for future reference and audits. Provide assurance that the system or equipment is suitable for its intended purpose and capable of producing safe, effective, and high-quality products or services. Design qualification is an important part of the overall validation process in regulated industries, and it helps to ensure that systems and equipment are designed and built to meet the desired performance and quality requirements before they are commissioned and used in actual production or service environments. The overall process of design qualification typically includes various steps. First of all, define design requirements. Clearly define the requirements and specifications for the system or equipment being designed. This includes identifying the intended use, performance criteria, regulatory and quality standards, and any other relevant requirements. Develop design documentation. Create comprehensive design documentation, such as design drawings, specifications, and other relevant documents that capture the design details and requirements. Review and approval. Conduct a thorough review of the design documentation by cross-functional teams, including engineers, quality assurance personnel, and other relevant stakeholders, to ensure that the design meets the defined requirements. Obtain necessary approvals from relevant parties. Testing and simulations. Conduct testing and simulations, as appropriate, to verify the performance, functionality, and safety of the design. This may include prototype testing, computer simulations, and other methods to validate the design. Risk assessment. Conduct a risk assessment to identify and evaluate any potential risks or hazards associated with the design. Mitigate identified risks through appropriate measures, such as design modifications or additional safety features. Documentation and record keeping. Maintain comprehensive documentation of the design qualification process, including design specifications, test results, risk assessments, and other relevant records. Final approval. Obtain final approval from relevant stakeholders, such as management, quality assurance, and regulatory authorities, before proceeding to the next stage of the project or system development. Periodic review and update. Regularly review and update the design documentation as needed throughout the project or system lifecycle to ensure that the design remains compliant with requirements and standards. Change control. Implement a robust change control process to manage any design changes or modifications and ensure that they are properly documented, reviewed, and approved. Verification and validation. Design qualification is part of the broader process of verification and validation, which includes other stages such as installation qualification, operational qualification, and performance qualification to ensure the overall compliance, functionality, and performance of the system or equipment. It's important to note that the specific steps and requirements of the design qualification process may vary depending on the industry, regulations, and company policies, and it's essential to follow the applicable guidelines and requirements in your specific context. You can find the download link for the design qualification sample protocol in the description of this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Thanks for watching this video.